The fall equinox is here. It's time for celebration. It's time to receive changes that's happening in this part of the universe, in this part of the world, where restructuring is happening. Restructuring of all the planets, the way the universal energy is flowing and coming to us. The change of the season. We are carefully opening the doors into our own potential that universe is ready to give us, is ready to offer to us at this time, at this universal time for this planet. We are opening the alignment through which those particular energies can come to everyone, and everyone who is open to receive it can receive it, can receive it into his or her body, into his or her physical body, letting those particular energies to come through and heal our emotions, heal our emotional body, our emotional traumas that we have been holding to for all our lives. Those particular energies are coming to heal all our emotional blocks, our emotional traumas, all the dramas of our life, all those places we felt like we were not heard or were not understood. It's going into those places where we feel that we are not seen, that we are alone. Those particular energies go inside of us to heal our loneliness, to heal disconnection, to heal the feelings of disconnection, the beliefs of disconnection, the beliefs that we are alone in this world. All those feelings and emotions about being lonely, that we are not supported, that we are on our own in this world. Feelings that nobody cares about us, about what we're doing. Feelings and beliefs of being disappointed is ourselves and our lives, is our achievements. Those particular energies go inside to heal those places, to heal those energies that can be anywhere in our body and in our energetic field. Those particular energies of equinox are coming through us. It's coming through all our lives, all our past lives, all our future lives, our parallel lives, and heals where those feelings, emotions, and beliefs of disconnect are happening in the places where they exist, and they go into the point where they were created to uncreated and disconnected from our beingness in this world. Disconnected from all our emotional, all our energetic field, to clear all these places out of our energetic field. Healing our energetic field, our sense of existence in this world, bringing back the sense of being whole, being complete, having everything that we need. Bringing back the sense that we are enough as we are at this moment. We are more than enough. We are complete human beings. That we are enough for this world. We are enough for this lifetime. That we are enough for each other and for ourselves. This information and sense of being whole and complete coming inside of our physical body cells, going through our cells and putting this information into the cells, so our body can remember and understand that we are whole and we are complete here and now, as we are at this moment. The sense of wholeness and being complete expands throughout all our existence, throughout all our beingness. it gets reflected in our, the way we breathe, the way we walk, the way we talk to each other and with ourselves. It's bringing out the best of ourselves, the best we could be for each other and for ourselves, for the world and for the universe, being truly who we are, with no excuses. Without being sorry. And we expand our borders this way to connect with other human beings, to connect with the society, to connect with the world of human beings, connecting with the world of nature, animals, plants, connecting with the world of minerals, connecting with the ground, the earth, connecting with the fire of the earth, connecting with the pleasure of existence in the physical world, connecting with the material world, with the world of things, seeing those worlds as extension of ourselves, as extension of our beingness, of our presence in the world. This world exists for us and because of us. We are here to spread the love. We are beings of love. We exist because of love. Love does exist inside of all things in the world of things. We are not here to judge the world of things. We are here to live through the world of things, experience universe through the world of things. The world of things is an extension of who we are and what we are, what we are doing in this world. To see that we can change anything in the world of things through our presence, through our beingness, through understanding of our own extension into the world of things. Seeing the world as an extension of ourselves. It's an important perception and understanding of this world. We can change what we want, the way we want it, and how we want it. We can change anything how we want it. The white light comes in to clear all the disconnection between us and the world of things. Between us and the world of imagination, connecting imagination with us and with the world of things. It's all interconnected. And it can open the doors to new possibilities, activating of all our sources of creation, activating the part of our brain to create, being creative, seeing new ideas, receiving new thoughts with new ideas, and making sure that those ideas become part of the material world, part of the world of things. Connecting directly the world of imagination with the world of things, where two of them become one. And two of them become whole. And now receiving the light from the sun. And receiving the light from the moon. We're receiving light from the stars, from the planet, from the planets that assist us, from other planets that are our friends and support humanity, this part of the universe, to grow and to expand into its own new possibilities of life and existence. The new things have to come through the ideas that come through the human mind, through your mind, your imagination, your inspiration, your desire to create. There are lots of energies in the universe. There are lots of universal forces that will support you on your own path, on your own creative journey. on your own path of being the creator, the creator of things in this world. Bring in the ideas, visions from the world of ideas into the world of things. So everybody can enjoy those ideas and those visions that you have in your mind. Be open to receive those inspiration. Be open to receive new ideas, not to fear them, but accept them. Encourage them in yourself and in each other to explore those new ideas, making them being true in material world. Let those universal God's inspirations to come through you with ease, to come through your hands and eyes, your mouth, come through your breath. Be inspired. Be in spirit. Be who you are. Be who you came here to be. That's your path. That's your mission. Your purpose. Your divine purpose. Being you, being inspired by being you. Let the God and the universe to bless you and give you lots of blessings. So be it. Amen.